Hello, everybody. I'm gonna stay here so I'm in the light. I have to look there to see if I'm in the light. Yeah, there you go. You have to feel like you have the sun in your eyes, otherwise it doesn't work. All right, so thank you so much for coming. This is a special night. We have a lot of important people here. Peggy is here, and the flowers are here, and we have it's so cool. What's that? Ines? Yeah. Hi, Ines. Long time no see. Hi. Yes, Ines. Yeah, she's the youngest one of the bunch. So, and then of course we have Boris and his mom is here. Everybody's here. And we have board members here. Ellen Hurwitz is here. Wendy Wallenberg is here. Of course, our executive director, Chris Belt, is here. Who else? And we have members. Do we have members? Yeah. Woohoo! Fantastic. And we have big donors here, too. So thank you so much for coming, and thank you for supporting Timucua. We've been doing this for almost 19 years. This is concert number 847, I believe. And that does not is not counting the rehearsals, the recitals, and the meetings and all that stuff. So, just concerts. And we have a new. I'm gonna skip. That's how my brain works. And if you can call that working. But we have a new trash system. So we have our cutlery. I'm pointing through you. The trash is over there. In the other room, and it's the system. And so our cutlery is now compostable and biodegradable. Everything you use tonight, except for the wine glasses, are biodegradable. So we have a bin that's for food waste only, and the other bin is for everything else except for glass and plastic bottles, and that gets recycled. And so we want to be as green as we can, and this is a step towards that. So thank you very much for helping us with that. We have three bathrooms, one on each floor, so please use them if you need them. We much prefer that to the alternative. And in case of emergency, I have to go fast. In case of emergency, you can leave the way you came in or use the exit on the west side in emergencies only. If you're in the balconies, you have to come down to exit. There's only bedrooms in there aside from bathrooms. So there's nothing good in there for you, only for me. So, all right, we have... just let me tell you a little bit what's coming up this summer. So we have two theater events coming up on the 23rd and 27th. Hannah Benitez is reading a play here. She's premiering four plays this year, and she's not even a playwright. She's an actor. That's pretty amazing. So I hope that you can come for that. And then the 27th is three stories. You're going to be sitting on stage. And then the action is going to happen on the balconies and on that side of the house, so that should be different. And then we take a short break for a couple of weeks, and then we come back July 6th, I think, we have three great events, and then we take another two-week break, and then August is filled with fantastic events. Like, we have great... South America, music from South America. We have another, we have new spoken word. We have classical, like Elena is coming back, the women's choir, don't want to miss that, and other classical events. And so it's really a good month. And so, but the flip side of that is last year, and I'm just warning you, last year a lot of the events were sold out in August. And so think ahead, reserve online, so you're assured to, of having a seat. Now, we have, wine glasses. So please silence your cell phone and disable the flash on it. You're welcome to take pictures and share them with the world. That's fine. And then you can be as enthusiastic as you want in between songs, but we appreciate that you be relatively quiet during the song so that we can have a good recording for the band. That's part of why they come here. Of course, they come to play for you. Wendy is holding a bowl. This used to be a fish bowl, but now it's a money bowl, because this event is pay what you want, and so we hope that you're going to pay what you want in there. And then your wine glass, when you're done for the evening, just bring it to the bar so we don't have to go hunting for it, because actually tonight, I have to make the videos tonight and pack, because I'm leaving tomorrow, and so I appreciate your help in helping me clean up a little bit, all right? Anything else I need to say before I introduce... That's good? Everything's good? Okay. So now... Oh, thank you. Happy Father's Day. Yes, yes. Happy Father's Day indeed. Thank you, Ellen. Always there to remind us what's true and important. Okay, so today is the first day of the residency for the Artist of the Month, and she is actually, you're the one of the first ones who showed here in this house, like very early on when we moved into this house. Wanda Ortiz, everybody. Wanda, come in. So her work is over there lit, except for that piece. That piece is a reward for the next business member. So if you want to, you know, get an ad there, you also get this reward. But every other piece that you see that's lit is her work. And anybody seen Wanda's work in the past? Yes.
Really?
Yes. And well, what you see here is quite different than what you might have seen before. But I will let Wanda tell you why she works, what she does, and so forth. Who are you?
How much time do you guys have? So thank you so much for coming, and thank you the people that have seen my work. I'm impressed. Thank you so much. Very cool, right? And for those of you who haven't, well, where have you been? Okay. No, so I'm known predominantly as a performance artist, right? In town, I've been making these works that are anchored in social justice. If you've seen the Pietà project or the Exodus project that just recently debuted at, where's that place? The Big Shiny place. Dr. Phillips, that's the place. See, I always want to make sure you guys were awake, okay? Because it's very cozy, but people might fall asleep. I wanted to, you know, test the room. But I'm trained as an illustrator. I teach at UCF. I teach drawing. And so a couple of other cool classes out there. I think they're cool anyway. I think so. I mean, I think they're cool. I don't know about anybody else. I think they're cool. So the root of all the work that I make comes from a very intimate, personal place. And so I don't usually show these kind of quiet drawings because the work that I make is so much bigger, these massive performances. But the root of all this work is family, it's relationship, it's very intimate spaces. So the Pietà Project, for those of you that do not know, may not be familiar with it, was a meditation on violence against Black and brown bodies. And I'm the mother, I'm a Puerto Rican woman, whoop whoop, from the Bronx, whoop whoop, yeah. Right? And my son is biracial. And so he's, you know, having a biracial child in the South in the shadow of Trayvon Martin is a very scary place to be. And so this big project was this meditation on shared grief and shared trauma and shared fear for our children and our children's safety. But the work that you see here are very intimate portraits of my son, myself in the back. The one over here is a selfie and a selfie right there. My son and myself is kind of like mother and child. And then there's a detail of a crown detail from one of the studies of the performance that I did. So if you have any questions, you can always ask me.
Is this for sale?
Yeah.
Is anything over $10,000?
Oh, no. I mean, y'all, if anybody wants to help me with my mortgage, that's cool. Some, like the one of my son, I'm sorry, that's for me. That's for me. But stuff is for sale. If you're interested and you want to, you know, want to grace your home with a little bit of boogie down, Puerto Rican, right? Absolutely. But I'll stop talking because the real reason you guys are here is over there. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
Wanda. Wanda's gonna work live, and
I have no idea what I'm gonna be.
Not only that, Wanda was like her plans changed at the last minute, and so she came here for her opening reception, which some of you talked to her during that. But she didn't think she was gonna work live for some reason.
Yeah.
So I found her a canvas and I found her some acrylic, and she's gonna improvise something.
Yeah.
So let's. All right. So, But please help me welcome the people you've come to see,
yes,
also with Wanda. And that is, I guess you'd call it, George, you'd call it the Swing Boutique, right?
Yes.
So let me, please help me welcome the Swing Boutique.
Well, thank you. It's a little overwhelming. All this fantastic hospitality that we've received. We've been here for a while, you know, doing sound checks and checking out the house, and it's pretty amazing. So we're very, very happy to be here. I'll introduce the band as we go, but we're going to start with some music. We play a lot of gypsy jazz, but also other continental slash French slash ethnic type music. We're going to start with a gypsy jazz standard written by Django Reinhardt and Stefan Grappelli, and it's called Douce Ambiance.
Ready?
Ready.
One, two.
You are very kind. let me just, if you like what you hear when somebody plays a solo, feel free to clap, okay? If you don't like it and you want to compliment us anyway, clap also. But anyway, so that's kind of a tradition in jazz, you know, after solos. I see some new people coming, so I'll wait with the introductions. We'll do a tune called Chanson d'Amour. If you know the band Manhattan Transfer, then, you know, they did a very famous version of this. We're going to do a version that's less famous, but not less good. In fact, no, I know. I know it's going to be better, and I am famous for my humility and my modesty. So, you know, I know what I'm talking about. Not just that, but we will do an experiment on this song that I haven't even heard before. It's the truth. Our bass player... we'll play this weird instrument called EVI at some point in the song. We've never rehearsed it. I mean, the song we have, but not this particular part of it. All right, so let's do Chanson d'amour.
Chanson d'amour. Je t'adore. Well, here in my heart, more and more, chanson d'amour. Chanson d'amour.
Better than Manhattan Transfer. All right, so this is Mr. Bo Fraser right here playing the violin. Bo Fraser.
Thank you.
John Keith on the accordion. Nick Rosacci on the upright bass and the EVI. And the EVI stands for? Electronic valve instrument.
Oh, that's almost.
And there's also an EWI, right, which is electronic wind instrument. And my name is George Grossman. Nothing windy, just the guitar and the vocal. Thank you. It took a while. We'll do a tune called Lullaby of the Leaves.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. That's later. Cradle me where southern sky. Watch me with a million eyes. Sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves. Cover me with heaven's blue. Let me sing a song or two. Sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves. And along with the breeze, I'm singing a song through the trees. By melody caressing the shore, familiar to me, I've heard it before. That Southland, now don't I know it in my soul? Don't I know I've reached my goal? Sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves. Boom. Thank you.
Watch me with a million eyes. Sing me to sleep. Lullaby of the leaves. Cover me with heaven's blue. Let me sing a song or two. Sing me to sleep. Lullaby of the leaves. Well, I'm breezing along, along with the breeze. I'm singing a song through the dream. That by melody caressing the shore, familiar to me, I've heard it before. That's how flat I know. I know it in my soul. Don't I know I've reached my goal? Sing me to sleep, lullaby of the leaves, lullaby of the leaves, lullaby of the leaves.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So this next tune has a Willett Bo switch instruments, and he'll play his mandolin. And this next tune has a kind of an interesting genesis. Let me tell you about it a little bit. So I was born and raised in Prague. You've been to Prague?
Yeah.
Well, if you've been there, you know it's one of the most beautiful cities, and certainly the most beautiful in Europe. And when I was a kid, this song that we're going to do now was a big hit on the radio. And I didn't know at the time that its origin was really a Spanish gypsy tune that was then made famous by this French, popular French singer. Then I heard a Czech version of it, you know, in Prague. And then I moved to Canada, where I lived for 30 years before coming down here. And one of my bands up in Canada played this song, and I wrote the English lyric to it. So it's got like four iterations. Iterations, is that too big a word for you? You understand what iteration? You can Google it, you know, you can use your phones. Yeah, good. It's not reiteration. So this is like the fourth version, so it probably originates in Spain, gypsy something. Then this French guy wrote it and put his name to it. And then this Czech singer sang it in Czech, and now we're gonna sing it in English. And one more thing, it's a kind of a sing-along tune. So if you feel like joining in, that's great. That'd be more than welcome. All right. It's called Nightingales of Madrid.
Ready? 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3. Under the blue Spanish skies, nightingales singing so sweetly. One look into her eyes, I know I'm lost completely. Some men prefer to flirt, but that goes against my thinking. Well, I don't want to get hurt, and I will just keep on drinking. About. Temptation is not yet behind me. I may be losing some ground. Their charms, they will not blind me. Some men prefer to dance, but that goes against my thinking. I'm not one for romance, and I will just keep on drinking. Thank you. sounding a sweet love alarm. Now it won't be too long before I succumb to her charm. Some men prefer to surrender, but that goes against my thinking. I will continue my bender, and I will just keep on drinking. Oh, let's hear it. Isn't that a great tune?
Yeah.
Did you sing? I couldn't hear you.
Were they singing?
Yeah, you were.
I'm too wrapped up in my own genius, so I can't be.
I'm a humble man.
Yes. Humility is my trademark. Anyway, we're going to feature John Keith here. This is a Parisian street waltz called Bal de la Marine.
So is he a street waltzer?
I'm sorry?
He's a street waltzer?
Yes, street waltzer, yes.
Never mind.
One, two, three, two.
Thank you.
All right, so we're going to continue with a couple of tunes by Django Reinhardt, Stefan Grappelli, who are kind of the main inspiration behind the band, not the only inspiration, but main ones. If you haven't heard of them, I hope you have, but if you haven't, Django Reinhardt was a Belgian gypsy guitar player whose style really was the only style of jazz that traveled in the wrong direction. Most of jazz went, you know, from America to Europe eastward, and he was really the only influential European jazz musician that made a big splash in the United States. But despite making a big splash, he actually had two performances at Carnegie Hall, and he overslept and didn't make the first one. You know, so that's how much he enjoyed New York. No offense, but he couldn't speak a word of English, and he didn't really like being in America. And so this was with Duke Ellington, by the way. So Duke Ellington's band is left stranded in Carnegie Hall while Django is, you know, played cards all night and into the morning. And so he slept. So they, you know, they ran to the hotel to wake him up. And by the time they woke him, he was playing cards. Didn't make it. He did make the second concert, but it's kind of emblematic of how he was. And he would do this, you know, he would just not show up for concerts. He would just, you know, go take, oh, I took my family on vacation, so, you know, I didn't show up. But when he played, he was absolutely unbelievably brilliant. And he wrote, he died very young at the age of 40, and he wrote these incredible, incredible tunes. We're going to play a couple of them. One last thing about Django, and Stefan Grappelli was his violin player who outlived him by many years, lived, I think, into his early 90s, I think, and played with many famous jazz musicians. But one other thing about Django was that when he was 18 years old, he was coming home. He came home from a gig, and they lived in a caravan. And his wife, he was already married and had a kid, and his wife, she made these toys or decorations out of cellophane, which is incredibly flammable. And she left the cellophane lying all over the caravan, and he came home from a gig and lit a cigarette and fell asleep. And of course, cigarette falls down, the whole thing, you know, caught on fire, and he barely escaped with his life, and his whole left side of his body was so badly burnt that, you know, the doctors say, not only will you not ever play again, you won't even walk. Well, he walked, and he relearned how to play. Instead of with four fingers, he could only play with these two, and he was better with two fingers than not only I will ever be, but then pretty much any guitar player will ever be. Okay, so that's the story. We're going to do two songs. One is called Dinette. I wrote the English lyric for this because originally it's just instrumental. And the one after that is a very, very, very famous Django tune called Minor Swing. But we'll do Dinette first.
By your charming grace, by your loving face. Every time we say goodnight, I dream of you till the morning light. I can't sleep, I just keep thinking of your love. Well, I knew right from the start my heart would be lost. Could not resist you at all, Dinette. Your honey and milk, your sugar and spice, you're my idea of paradise. Can't run and hide, I'm bound and tied, I'm forever yours.
You take it, Bo.
Well, your honey and milk, your sugar and spice, you're my idea of paradise. Can run and hide, I'm bound and tied, I'm forever yours.
All right. And now this is Django's greatest, well, he had two great hits. We have them both on the program tonight. This is probably the greatest hit called Minor Swing. Usually we end the show with it, but we're so excited to be here that we actually stuck it in the middle of the show.
Or I guess it's a reason to leave early, right?
Oh my God, no.
This could be the end of the show.
All right, here we go. Minor Swing. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So this band inspires me a lot, so I write a lot of tunes for the band. This next one is an original of mine called Paris in the Rain. And I think that, you were planning to play the EVI on that?
Sure am.
All right. Well, this is going to be interesting. Again, we have not rehearsed this before.
They haven't even heard it yet, so good luck, guys.
So, I guess Nick is the. I gotta play the intro on this?
Sure.
Okay.
I think I've been fired.
Yeah. No. Just. Temporarily relieved.
My instrument doesn't flash like his.
Shining bright, not a cloud in the sky. I'm feeling fine, my spirits are high. I'm feeling fine, but it's just not the same walking with you in Paris in the rain. Walking with you in Paris in the rain. Accordions play Champs-Élysées in a midnight cafe. Sweet stolen kiss in a dark winding lane. And I'm walking with you in Paris in the rain. Walking with you in Paris in the rain. Those days are gone, I must live in the now. Those days are gone, and yet still somehow I see your lips and you're smiling again. I'm walking with you in Paris in the rain. Walking with you in Paris in the rain. Shining bright, not a cloud in the sky. I'm feeling fine, my spirits are high. I'm feeling fine, but it's just not the same like walking with you in Paris in the rain. Walking with you in Paris in the rain.
Thank you. We're going to continue with two more of Django's and Stefan's compositions. We'll do Swing 42 first, then we'll do Nuage, and then we'll do a real fun song after that. Okay? Everybody having a good time tonight? Thank you. If you'd like to know more about the band, you can talk to me later, and I'll distribute our cards, you know, and all that good stuff that goes with the commerce of music, because, of course, we're in it to get rich.
Bad news for you.
Yeah. It's okay. I'm a little older, so I know it's just a fable. No. When you first start, you get into it because you love it, and then you keep going. You go, well, this is great. I'm getting pretty good at it. Maybe I'll make some money at it. And then you look around. There's people making money, like, you know, in my time, you know, Elton John. I'm like, okay, well, I can make a lot of money like Elton John. And then you keep working, you know, bars, mostly bars, where they have TV screens above your heads and watching football. And you go, I don't think that Elton John ever did this, you know. And I've been doing it for 18 years now, you know. So anyway, you keep doing it, you know, and you keep doing it. And occasionally you play in old folks' home where people, you know, listen to you and they want you to play great tunes like, you know, Duke Ellington, which you love playing. But once again, it's great and, you know, the money's decent. But again, you don't think Elton John ever played a gig like that. And at that point, you're like 55 and you go, well, you know, so maybe not Elton John or, you know, Joni Mitchell, but maybe like, you know, second tier. Now, I don't know. I can't think of anybody second tier right now. But and so then you keep working.
Who?
Nothing.
Oh, nothing.
They're
just chatting behind my back. Is that what they're doing?
No.
Okay, that's disrespect. Now you're fired. Anyway, long story short. My long story is never short. Okay, so you kind of realize that. And so then when you get to a place like this. And you know, hey man, this is what it's about. So thank you so much for coming out. You guys are great. And above all, thank you to Benoit Glazer for making this possible. And without further ado,
Oh.
All right, well, I think we'll do, what, do you have patience for about 15, 20 minutes more? All right. All right, well, we got a couple of fun tunes for you now. They're both about vipers. But we're not talking snake, okay? We're talking 1930s, 1940s slang for smoking illicit substances. Yeah. When you did it back then, you were called a viper. Now you're called a vapor. So. Thank you.
Which one?
Good question, John. Which one? Well, we've done two Djangos, right? So we're going to take a break from Django. We're going to do this tune, which was, I believe, written by Stuff Smith, actually. Oh. Fats Waller had a hit with it, but it was written by Stuff Smith, and it's called When You're a Viper. And I know my wife, Diane's here. She loves this song. This is her favorite. Well, her second favorite song. Anyway, when You're a Viper. We cool? We cool. Key of G. About Aretha, 5 foot long, mighty miss, but not too strong. You'll get high, but not for long. When you're a viper, I'm the king of everything. I gotta get high before I can swing. Light a tea and let it be. When you're a viper, you get high, your mouth is dry, everything is dandy. Truck on down to the corner store, bust your mouth on peppermint candy. Now you know your body's spent. You don't care if you don't pay the rent. The sky is high, so am I. When you're a viper, strong. You'll get high, but not for long. When you're a viper, I'm the king of everything. I gotta get high before I can sing. Light a tea and let it be. When you're a viper, your mouth is dry. When you get high, everything is dandy.
truck on down to the corner store. Bust your mouth on peppermint candy. Now you know your body's spent. You don't care if you don't pay the rent. Sky is high, so am I. When you're a viper, well, sky is high, so am I. Viper!
All right, let's do another Viper song, and then after that we'll do Moshe Mitspilkas, and then we're gonna do C.C. Bon, and then we'll call it a night. All right, so this is another Viper song. This one is a Django tune, and it's called Viper's Dream. One, two, three. Yeah! Couple more songs. This next tune, again, we're gonna do the EVI experiment on this. Approximate the sound of a clarinet. This tune started about, I'm gonna say 12, 13 years ago. I had a gig up in Canada playing on a train. It was one of these excursion trains where people would watch in the fall, the leaves turning and stuff like that. And I had a gig, me and a trumpet player played during the ride. It was, and you know, if you tend to get motion sickness, you would not be able to do that gig because we had to stroll through two cars full of, you know, people who drank a lot, and you know, and the whole time it's like this, you know, the whole time, and then you play, and of course it's easier for me. I don't know how he was able to play the trumpet, but he did. So anyway, during one of those rides, we had a break, like a 45 minute break, and I wrote this next tune, and I called it Lester the Jester, and it has a very decidedly Jewish theme to it. I am Jewish, and it is kind of my, you know, it comes from some 1,000-year-old tradition or something. And so I thought, Lester the Jester totally doesn't fit, you know. So now it's called Moshe Mitspilkes. Any Jewish people here? A couple. So, you know, Moshe is a name, Mit is with, Spilkes, ants in your pants. So Moshe Mitspilkes. We're going to start with the EVI, and then we'll bring the band in. All right? Check this out. Rosacci on the clarinet. All right, folks, we're gonna almost wrap it up. We're gonna do two songs that give B flat.
Oh man.
The first one is called Ceci Bon, and the last one is Ain't She Sweet, because that's a song that we play no matter where in the world we play. And God is my witness, I've played in a lot of places in the world because I've lived in this my sixth country. So I've lived all over the place, including Iceland. For a few years. Yeah. Oh, there's enthusiasm for Iceland? You obviously haven't lived there. it's a great place, but between November and the beginning of March, you'd better get out of there if you don't go to insane. It's completely dark. So, you know, but a very good place. And I had a very successful blues band in Iceland. I also lived in Israel. I lived in the UK. Thank you. I lived in the UK for 3 years and Canada most of my adult life. And, of course, born and raised in Prague. And then down here. And Orlando, I moved to Orlando. And then 3 years ago, we moved to Winter Haven, which you might find on the map. I'm not sure if you do, but it's actually a pretty nice place. Once you've lived there for about 16 years, you'll get used to it. It's okay, yeah. It's like playing guitar. You know what they say when my students ask me about playing, how hard is it? I say, well, the first 30 years are the toughest. Yeah. All right, well, we'll do C'est si bon. C'est si bon. Lovers say that in France, when they thrill to romance, because it's all so good. Oh, c'est si bon. And so I say it to you, I like the French people do, because it's all so good. Well, every word, every sigh, every kiss dear, leads to only one thing, and that is this dear, c'est si bon. Nothing else can replace, and just your slightest embrace. Well, if you only could be my own for the rest of my days, I would whisper this phrase, my darling, c'est si bon. Oh, c'est bon. John Keith on the accordion. C'est bon. Nothing else can replace, just your slightest embrace. But if you only could be my own for the rest of my days, I would whisper this phrase, my darling, c'est si bon. One more time, folks. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You are an awesome audience. Thank you to Benoit. Thank you, Orlando. Even though the magic didn't do so good and the Toronto Raptors did great.
Oh, man.
She finished the picture, by the way.
Yes, well, we're not done.
Okay, but I just wanted to...
Yes. Man, you interrupt my train of thought. Okay, so once more, I just want to thank you all for coming out, and Bo Fraser here on the fiddle.
Thank you.
And the mandolin. John Keith on the accordion. Yeah. Nick Rosacci on the bass. Yeah. George Grossman on the guitar. And where is our wonderful artist? Where has she gone? I could do that. Not. Yeah, the first 30 years are the toughest.
walking down the street, I ask ya very confidentially, ain't she sweet? Oh, ain't she nice? Look over once or twice, I ask you very confidentially, ain't she nice? Or just one look in her direction, oh me, oh my, well she's perfection. Ain't she neat from her head down to her feet? Well, I ask ya very confidentially, ain't she sweet? Direction. Oh me, oh my. She's sweet perfection. Ain't she neat from her head down to her feet? I ask ya very confidentially, ain't she sweet? Oh well, I ask you very confidentially, ain't she sweet? Oh well, I ask you very confidentially. I said, ain't she sweet?
She started it.